Hello, aspirants. Looking at current affairs for 7th Feb, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these 15. We'll look at them in detail. The first one, likely misuse no ground to strike down Aadhaar. So this is the 5-judge constitutional bench hearing the Aadhaar case. So further arguments in this case took place, and the judge hearing in this case, Justice D.Y. Chandrachur, has orally observed that mere possibility of misuse cannot be a ground to strike down Aadhaar Act, because earlier too in various judgments, the Supreme Court has held that mere possibility of misuse cannot lead to striking down of any legislation. So here the senior advocate representing the petitioner, Mr. Kapil Sibal, has said that misuse is not just a possibility, it is happening. Misuse exists. Personal data is already out in the public domain, and he says that once a genie is out of the bottle, it cannot be put back. So even if, you know, possible major misuse is also possible in the future, then Aadhaar should be treated as an exception to those line of judgments, consistent line of judgments which are being, you know, put forth by the judiciary. So this is the statement being made. He also said that RTI Act of 2015 made the citizens more powerful, and now the Aadhaar Act wants to make the state more powerful. So he's comparing the two acts in this manner. So arguments have been taking place, and further arguments would also take place in this matter, Aadhaar case. Then next is, LET militant escapes from hospital. So this 22-year-old Lashkar-e-Toyba militant from Pakistan, who was arrested, was in custody, has escaped from custody of the jail officials. Two policemen also guarding this operative were killed. He was actually being escorted, taken to Srinagar hospital for a checkup. And there were six Pakistani prisoners who were being moved, and in this one LET militant, Abu Hanzula, as he is known as, Hanzula, has escaped. It has led to death of two policemen. So this is the details of this LET operative is provided here. He is from Pakistan. Then next is, Kulbhushan Jadhav to undergo another trial. So Indian national Kulbhushan Jadhav, he has been in news for a long time now. We have been following this case with every detail coming forth. He was sentenced to death in 2017 by a Pakistani military court on charges of espionage. Espionage means spying. So now another trial is set to be undertaken now on charges of terrorism and sabotage. So he has such charges also slapped on him now. Pakistani court has already sentenced him to death. So this is a military court, and is said their death sentence is on a mercy petition before the military chief, military general Javed Kamal Bajwa. So it is still pending before him. So this is there. He was actually arrested from Baluchistan province in 2016, according to Pakistan, whereas India says that he was actually arrested from Iran. He was on a business in Iran's Chabahar port from where he was arrested. So he is a retired naval official, and Pakistani authorities claim that he is a serving Indian naval official recruited by ROC, Research and Analysis Wing, to supervise terrorist activities in Baluchistan and Karachi. This is there. Also, consular access was not provided to India for Kulbhushan Jadhav. So the consulate, the Indian representatives were not allowed to meet him. Though later we have seen his mother and wife visited him in jail in Pakistan. That also resulted into a diplomatic tiff, which we have already discussed in news. So here now India has already appealed before ICJ, International Court of Justice. An International Court of Justice has stayed the execution of Mr. Jadhav. So the death sentence has already been stayed by ICJ. India has approached claiming that Pakistan has violated international conventions by denying consular access to Mr. Jadhav. So on this reason, we have got stay order on the death sentence. So here, these are the details regarding the death sentence being provided by a military court too. So this military courts have been introduced in Pakistan by an amendment in 2015. And they were actually, you know, these military courts were to be automatically disbanded after 2 years from 2015. But days before Jadhav's conviction, the Pakistan Senate passed an amendment extending it for another 2 years. Then next is oil tanker with 22 Indian sailors released by pirates in West Africa. So in West Africa here in the Gulf of Guinea, Indian sailors were also on board this oil tanker MT Marine Express. There were 22 Indian sailors here. So this oil tanker was hijacked by pirates off the coast of West Africa. India also sought assistance from these West African countries, Nigeria and Benin. And with the assistance, this week-long crisis has ended. All the crew members are safe now. The cargo is also intact. The oil tanker was carrying 13,500 tons of petroleum products. So it was hijacked from, the pirates hijacked it from Gulf of Guinea, which is a major zone of maritime commerce, but is vulnerable to sea pirate attacks. So here region is shown here. And this is regarding the details of this particular case too. So here you can see it went missing off Benin's coast. The ship actually has this ship security alert system, but that was switched off by the pirates. So in case of threat, to security such as a pirate attack, this alarm located on the ship can be activated by the crew. So once alert goes to the country where the ship is flagged, and another to the designated security officer of the company. So through satellite contact, this switch works. But then generally, once the pirates hijack the ship, then attack the ship, then they switch off these systems. There's also an automatic information system on board the ship. This gives information of the location, the previous port of call, etc. over a short distance. So the nearest port would get these details. Satellite phones are also being used by ships today. So they can make calls from anywhere in the world to anywhere. So this is also there. So the adjoining countries here, Benin, Nigeria, assistance was sought and this crisis resolved. Then next is 21 contract HIV after quack reuses syringe. So at least 21 persons have been found to have contracted HIV in UP's Unnao district. And the allegation is put on a quack who administered injections to them using a common syringe. So sharing syringe is not recommended at all. It is a way in which HIV can spread as such too. And this quack means doctors. They're not actually doctors, but they're practicing medicine. So these are quacks which are generally seen in villages. So here we have this case in which quacks mistake has resulted in 21 people contracting HIV. So a criminal case has been filed against him. Actually, these HIV cases were discovered in two rural areas in this region. The screening camp was held by State Health Department. Even the State Health Department had this screening camp done because there were earlier health camps held by NGOs in which it showed high incidence of HIV in the district hospitals here. So after this, State Health Department also conducted screening camps and it found these HIV cases, and prima facie the allegation has been put on this quack. Also, the government is probing other angles in this case too, that even the high incidence of migration and transit in this region, where truck drivers pass through this region and it's also become a center of sex, may be a reason for high levels of HIV in this region. So that is also being looked into. Then next is, don't dump junk. We are not garbage collectors. Supreme Court to center. So this is a case before the Supreme Court, a petition which has been filed, a PIL on implementation of solid waste management rules 2016. So in this case, the central government has submitted an 845-page compilation of the central government on solid waste management. So this compilation is an affidavit submitted, it's collection of schemes, official correspondence and other documents on solid waste management across the country. So the Supreme Court has refused to accept this and take it on record, saying that this is junk. This does not have any information and we are not garbage collectors, don't give us junk here. So this is a statement coming from the judiciary. The advocate representing the government said that the bench would be presented with a properly compiled and column-wise details of as an affidavit. So this will come within 3 weeks, has been assured. So the Supreme Court bench here wanted to know whether the states and union territories had constituted the state level advisory bodies on state solid waste management in accordance with the 2016 rules or not. So what steps are being taken by the state government is being inquired into. It is seen that the central government said only 22 states have bothered to respond as such. Others have not even responded. Even there were solid waste management rules 2000. So the Supreme Court also highlighted this, that you framed rules in 2000, nobody implemented it. Again, you came up with rules in 2016, nobody is interested. So what is happening on solid waste management is being questioned by the Supreme Court. The advocate representing the government has said that for solid waste management, the main problem was non-availability of land, especially in major cities like Delhi. This has been highlighted that there's a need to set up waste to energy plants, but then there is no land available. So what are these solid waste management rules? We can see here. So the source segregation of waste has been mandated to channelize waste to wealth by recovery, reuse and recycle. So this is very important that waste should be segregated at source. Also, responsibilities have been given to generators of waste. They have to segregate waste. So that is in three categories, that is wet waste, dry waste and domestic hazardous waste. And so the authorized rag pickers or waste collectors or even local bodies have to collect this segregated waste. And if they don't, then they will have to pay a user fee to waste collector and spot fine for littering and non-segregation. So this provision is also there. Even large residential complexes also have the responsibility to segregate waste at source. So here you can see these rules. They mandate that all buildings like residential, institutional or industrial with more than 5,000 square meter area are liable to ensure segregation of biodegradable waste at source. And this biodegradable waste will have to be processed, treated and disposed of through composting method. So this is one major provision in this solid waste management rules. Of course, there is opposition to these rules because it is putting onus on individual households. One, waste to energy plants are costly as such too. Also, all these rules presently remain on paper. They have not been implemented effectively. Even the government is not ready and the people are not ready. So steps needed to be taken in this direction have not been enforced effectively. That is why the PIL petition was filed and the Supreme Court is hearing this matter. Then next is 111 killed in 822 communal incidents last year, Minister. So this is actually Union Minister giving details regarding the number of deaths which have taken place in communal incidents. So it is said that there have been 822 communal incidents in 2017. So this is higher than 2016 figure of 751. And in these communal incidents, as many as 111 people were killed and 2,384 injured. So this even within this, the highest number of communal incidents were from the state of Uttar Pradesh. Then comes Karnataka, Rajasthan, even Gujarat witnessed 50 riots, Bihar, West Bengal, Maharashtra. Number of communal riots have been high. So this is the status report being filed. You can see the number of incidents taking place over the years, number of deaths and number of injured have increased from 2016. Though in 2016 they seem to have decreased, at least the incidents and number of persons killed, but they have increased now in 2017. Then next is CJ is appointed for 5 states. The central government has appointed new chief justices in 5 high courts, that is in Karnataka, Kerala, Manipur, Meghalaya and Tripura. So here the collegium, Supreme Court collegium, had made recommendations in January 2018, and now based on these recommendations, these 5 new chief justices have been appointed by the government. Then next is Agni 1 test fired off the Odisha coast. So this is the Agni 1 nuclear capable short range ballistic missile which has been indigenously developed by the country. It's a surface to surface missile. So this Agni 1 missile is actually inducted and it is part of the present test was part of the periodic training activity by the Strategic Forces Command of the Army to consolidate its operational readiness. So this testing was done. It's having a range of 700 kilometers, Agni 1. It was tested from the integrated test range at the Dr. Abdul Kalam Island of Odisha coast. So this is the island which was earlier known as Wheeler Island, where the integrated test range is located. And this trial has been called complete success. All mission objectives were achieved. So this is there. The Agniwan missile is propelled by a solid rocket propellant system. It is equipped with specialized navigation system that ensures that the missile reaches the target with high degree of precision. So this is there. Then next is Bhutan, Nepal, Bangladesh to be part of India's tiger census. So India's tiger census, which is conducted once in 4 years. So it has been conducted presently to its exercise began in 2017. The last census which was conducted was in 2014. So you can see from 2006, the number of tigers in India have rose in 2010 and further increase has been seen in 2014 data also. So this is because of improved conservation measures and even new estimation methods being used. So the Wildlife Institute of India, the University of Union Environment Ministry funded body is tasked with coordinating this exercise since 2006. So once in 4 year tiger estimation exercise takes place, but now presently this will be the first time that in this exercise adjoining nations, Bhutan, Nepal and Bangladesh would also coordinate. So it will be a coordinated effort. Earlier Nepal and Bangladesh have worked together in the tiger counting, the number of tigers in the region. So this is there. So this exercise, which is having has an estimate of 10 crores rupees 10 crores required. So it is commissioned by the Union Environment Ministry. The National Tiger Conservation Authority is responsible. So here you can see the survey collects information regarding number of tigers too, and also estimation of prey population like of deer and other animals is also done. That information is also collected. It requires a huge number of officials, like 40,000 forest guards traversing around 4 lakh square kilometer of forests. Wildlife biologists, etc. required for this. Camera traps are placed. So these forest guards presently have also got Android apps and Android phones and apps to store the data, because earlier manual listing of this data resulted in errors. So even apps have been provided to them, Android phones and apps to store data regarding the tiger estimation. So here this is there. Then next is 75 militants gunned down in 2017. So even number of infiltration cases in India reported in 2017 has been high. There have been 515 cases of infiltration from across the border in Jammu and Kashmir in 2017. And in this year, even number of militants killed have been 75. So compared to 2015, it's a 130% jump in the figures. So here you can see 2015 and 16 figures are also provided. So the number of cases are increasing over the years. But then the Union Minister of State for Home, Mr. Rijiju, said that security forces are taking all appropriate measures to strengthen overall security, including an operational grid with enhanced human intelligence and technical intelligence grid being used at the borders to deal with insurgency activities. But it seems infiltration cases have been on the rise over the years. Even government is said to have approved construction of bunkers for the protection of people living along the international border and LOC in Jammu and Kashmir. But the fact placed before the Lok Sabha shows that infiltration cases and number of militants killed have risen over the years. Then next is Nasheed seeks Indian military intervention in Maldives. So we have been discussing regarding the Maldives political crisis. Here, the exiled former president of Maldives, Mohammad Nasheed, who is in UK, he has sought India's military intervention in the country to release dissidents who are in prison. So we had seen yesterday too that former president Mamoun Abdul Gayoom, the 80-year-old former president, has been put under detention. So he and also other leaders who fear that they would be arrested too. Even the Supreme Court has been controlled by the military now. So the military has entered in and the judges have also been arrested. So all these political detainees, judges and former president need to be freed. And for this, Mohammad Nasheed seeks India's military intervention. He says that there's a need for steps that need to be taken. So this is a request being made. So Maldives President Mr. Yameen has imposed emergency. We have already seen that yesterday. Emergency for 15 days has been imposed. Though this emergency has to be approved by the parliament, but parliament has been suspended. So these are the things which are going on in Maldives presently. Even UN Secretary General Mr. Antonio Guterres has called the government in Mali to lift the state of emergency and guarantee the safety of the citizens, including members of the judiciary. So this is there. So here you can see the details are also provided, which we have been discussing over time. Then next is RBI likely to keep repo rate on hold. So the 6-member monetary policy committee of RBI will have its last meeting for this financial year, in which it is expected, this news will come forth tomorrow. So it is expected that the status quo would stay on the repo rate. So because the target is that inflation should remain within limits, and inflation target is of keeping it at 4% with plus minus 2% band. So means maximum inflation can go up to 6%, and for the December month inflation was 5.21%, just a little below 6% upper band mandate for the RBI Monetary Policy Committee. So this Monetary Policy Committee has 6 members, out of which 3 members are from RBI and 3 are appointed by the government as such. So the reason for this high inflation is also rising food prices. So that is one main reason. It has been a 17-month high retail inflation, which we are seeing presently. And also inflation is expected to further increase because of rising oil prices internationally too, and also higher minimum support prices for farmers, which has been promised in the Union Budget 2018. So that is why it is expected the repo rate would remain unchanged in this present monetary policy review meeting, and the central bank's neutral stance would also stay. So it will remain, this neutral stance means it will see further that how the interest, how the inflation rates go, according to it repo rate may go up, high or low. So it's neutral. So here you can see the details provided regarding monetary policy committee. So these are the 3 RBI members. The chairperson of Monetary Policy Committee is RBI Governor Mr. Urjit Patel. So decisions are taken by majority vote. RBI Governor gets to vote again if there is a tie, and at least 4 members are needed for quorum. And these are all 6 members, the government nominees also listed here. So non-RBI members appointed for 4 years by the government. And as we discussed, casting vote is there, and target is keeping inflation at the level of 4% with plus minus 2% band allowed. Then next is, now bacteria can turn toxic metals into gold. So scientists have found this new metal gobbling bacteria. This is rod-shaped bacteria C. metalludurans. So this bacteria is found in soils enriched with heavy metals. And here it is seen, it is said to be ingesting toxic metallic compounds. So it ingests these toxic metallic compounds and still continues to thrive, and it extracts valuable trace elements. So means it gives out these nuggets of gold as a side effect. So this has been seen. So high concentration of heavy metals like copper and gold are actually toxic to most living creatures. But then this is not the case for this bacteria. So it continues to thrive and gives out gold nuggets. So this bacteria is said to be playing a key role in the formation of so-called secondary gold also. So primary gold is the ancient gold ores, and here it is breaking down heavy metals and extracting valuable trace elements from it. So this is C. metalludurans rod-shaped bacteria. Then the last news item is SpaceX rocket to Mars blasts off, puts sports car in space. So this is SpaceX, a private space company from USA, which is having its new rocket, Falcon Heavy, blasted off. So it was its first test flight of this Falcon Heavy, and it carried a red sports car of Tesla Roadster. So it is on a trip to Mars now. So this Falcon Heavy rose from the same launch pad at Kennedy Space Center in USA, which NASA had been using as such. 50 years ago, NASA sent men to moon from Kennedy Space Center. And now this SpaceX has launched its Falcon Heavy. The rocket is said to be the most powerful rocket in use today. It has 3 boosters and 27 engines. Even out of these 3 boosters, 2 are recycled from previous launches. And SpaceX, the private company, has its chief executive Elon Musk, who is also head of the electric car maker Tesla. So this Tesla Roadster has been used for this as a payload in Falcon Heavy. And Falcon Heavy is a combination of three Falcon 9 rockets. The rockets which the SpaceX company has been using to ship supplies to the International Space Station and lift satellites to. So even International Space Station was being serviced by this private space company SpaceX, which was roped in by NASA because NASA's space shuttles had retired. So this is it. And it is said, unlike most rockets out there, Falcon Heavy receives no government funding. So this is also there. It's a private company. So it will be going to Mars. It is said that Roadster will reach the vicinity of Mars in 6 months if it weathers all the obstacles which may come in its path. So this is the news. So there was also views from the public sought regarding what payload should SpaceX carry, and what has been finalized is this Tesla Roadster car, which has been carried to space by Falcon Heavy now. So these are the news items. Thank you.